York. It is snowing, but I'm here for a very exciting reason indeed. I am here, God, it is so windy. I am here for the Papakata open weekend. Now, Papakata, if you haven't heard from them, where have you been? Papakata are the most amazing wedding company, and I am lucky enough to be having my wedding with them. But I thought I'd bring you with me today and show you the just brilliant things that I'm gonna have at my wedding, which I can't wait. And if you're getting married, perhaps this will inspire you to use one of Papakata's tents, or we'll get some advice from them as well, see what they can tell us about getting married, all the things that you should probably do, which now that I'm only 4 months away, I wish that I'd known before. God, there are so many things, but I can't wait to show you inside these gorgeous tents. But for now, I'm getting inside, bloody freezing. Walk inside one of these bad boys, I'll be a missus. Can you even believe it? Here it is in all of its glory, the sperry tent. Yay!
You had me at a low, 'cause where you go is where I go. I don't need nobody else, I got you, and you got me too.
You came right out of the blue. I wanna do what you want to. We can leave and run away someday, someday.
It's looking good.
Thank you. So as well as having a sperry, this gorgeous being here, Papakata also have these tipis, which are incredible. And actually, it was a really hard decision to make. I didn't know whether to choose a tipi or a sperry. It was literally the decision of the century. But we did decide on a sperry, but I think that equally are absolutely stunning. So cozy. I think this is, I mean, you can have it as a summer wedding as well, but I think this is perfect if you want to have the winter wedding, then obviously maybe a teepee might be better. So let's have a little look inside at this one too.
Staring into your blue eyes. We don't need nobody else. I got you, and you got me too.
I will be married, but I'm sitting here with Amanda, who owns Papakata, and Kate, my lovely, lovely wedding planner, who has helped me through all of my times of worrying. So Kate, you little gem of a human. But before I tell you the obvious why you stand out, what do you think makes you different to other people in wedding land?
Well, I mean, the sperrys are a prime example of what makes us unique. We're the only people in the UK that have sperrys. They're exclusively ours, and they're from America, and they're built from the Hamptons, so they're super glamorous.
Yeah.
They have this amazing geometric design, and they're actually a canvas structure, mm-hmm. which is really rare for this style of tent.
Yeah.
And I think the canvas gives to that natural feel yeah. and the height of them, so they have a real presence.
I love the height of them.
And warmth as yeah. well, because of the oyster colour. They're not yeah. white, so there's a real warmth.
And yeah, they don't feel cold.
That's the difference as well, I found, because I've looked at other marquees, which, you know, is fine, but I think that with these, they do have that kind of warm feeling about yeah. them. So even in the winter, they'll
well,
be
yeah,
fine.
Prime example today.
Yeah, exactly.
Snowing outside
yeah. and it's such a sell.
Yeah, exactly.
Exactly. Amazing.
And the light's really flattering as well.
Yeah.
Just like yeah.
True.
Fantastic
true.
Wedding images, you know.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
You're welcome.
Thanks so much, Kate. Obviously, you have seen me in all of my time of planning this wedding. She's grinning because she knows. What I mean, I have been very indecisive.
No.
I wouldn't say that I've been bridezilla, but I've been an anxiety
you think
queen.
You're a bridezilla, and you're nowhere near.
I've been an anxiety
nothing.
Queen, like asking you a million times over. What kind of things can you put? Like, what would you say are the things that maybe they like worry about, and they shouldn't bloom and worry about, like me?
Well, the weather. To start
yeah,
with,
shouldn't
obviously.
Worry.
Should not worry, because regardless of what it is outside,
yeah.
these tents, as Amanda said, are just so warm. The glow in them is just beautiful.
Yeah.
Regardless of teepee or sperry, so you know, if you're looking for a teepee as well, they're just, yeah, the weather is one thing that I know you think could ruin your day,
yeah.
but it's not going to.
Okay.
Absolutely
not. We've had some of our best testimonials from rain, because
yeah.
people always say that if it's hot and sunny, people go outside and spread around the tent.
Yeah.
Whereas if the weather's not so good, they all have to come together
yeah.
inside and have a bit of a powwow. So,
yeah. That's
you know,
true.
So actually some people prefer
that's true.
Not
and I guess that's the thing, is like if you are going to have like an outdoor wedding,
yeah.
is maybe plan for that happening.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
And the contingency of that. So if you're
yeah.
reception drinks are outside, potentially having the contingency of fitting them inside. If, you know, having your guests at space on the dance floor, or utilising what you've booked to make it so that there is, you know, space regardless of where you are.
Mm-hmm.
So obviously the garden is the ideal, but
yeah.
the tent is also there and usable for reception drinks
yeah.
and for evening, free food, all of that sort of stuff.
I've definitely noticed since being a bride that there is such, wedding industry is a big industry.
Is it?
I'm guessing over the 12 years you've seen it go from this kind of, oh, it's, you know, it's always about lovely to get married, but it has become a big business as well. How have you managed? Because I feel like at the heart of this, it's still like all about having fun. You said the best parties happen in a Papakata tent. How have you kept like the ever-growing industry? A, you kept yourself like afloat, and also made yourself so unique in that it is still about all just having a party. It's not really, I don't find, from being a customer of yours, all about take, take, take.
I think for us it's about actually we completely passionate and love what we do, but it's like it's also the team that we've employed, so we make sure that we have people who are equally as passionate as weddings.
Yeah.
So even though we did 350 last year alone,
yeah.
each one felt like the first one we'd ever done, and we were so excited, and we
yeah.
treated it like it was the most important that we'd ever
yeah.
done. I think as well, we also understand that a wedding is that it's about an amazing party, but it's about a union of two people and two families. And I think it's ultimately, some people can lose that in the planning, and it's helping our brides to keep a perspective
yeah.
of what a wedding is actually about.
Yeah.
And that the things that your guests will remember are the atmosphere and the love between the couple.
Yeah.
Not necessarily whether your candle is grey or like stable grey.
I need to remember that.
Gray.
Yeah. So not, okay, right. It's about love. Oh, I didn't realise. Sorry, I forgot that bit.
I'm saying all this, but when I got married,
yeah.
I remember saying at my wedding.
But I got, like, even you just saying then, I was like a bit like, wow, I knew you did a lot of weddings, but 350 weddings.
Yeah,
or
event sessions, yeah.
But still, and that is exactly, and I'll come over to my little friend here, because, you know, you're a big part of my day, but that is exactly why you are so successful, because I honestly feel like I'm your only bride.
Yeah, and that is, and
like, who are these people? Who's even here? Sorry, this is my tent.
We're just laying them low.
Yeah,
it's
no.
fine. It's
see what
fine.
They can have
yeah.
next year yeah. when mine's over.
But
that's what I don't feel like anybody else
no.
getting married. That's how you've made me feel. I'm not just saying this for
yeah.
this, I really truly mean that.
But I feel that and actually that's a real, some people used to say, oh, you know, you're getting bigger, you're not as personal or intimate, but it's rubbish.
No.
It's absolutely rubbish, because ultimately we have the most amazing experience, we've got the right equipment, we've got spares of everything.
Yeah.
If your tent, which it won't, collapses or splits, we will be there within hours to change it for you, and that is the benefit of working with a company that has that kind of experience.
Yeah. A Papa Man, isn't it?
Yeah.
We've got a Papa Man. I love that.
Yeah. You know, and I think that's the reassurance that we can give you. But you know, you have had your own event planner from the start who will be with you all the way. And I think that's how it feels so intimate to you. And,
Speaking of which, here she is. Kate, you have been exactly what Amanda just said. Like, I definitely feel that with Papakata, that you have been like my little guardian angel throughout this process. And especially me not knowing ever what I kind of wanted from a wedding day.
Yeah.
So you literally, as soon as someone is kind of says, I want a Papakata wedding, you get assigned a person. You're an event manager for that person the whole process.
The whole way through. So, you know, site visits, floor plans, done a thousand, you know.
Told ya. Anxiety central here.
But that's what we're there for, you know. And if you're undecided on your floor plan, or you don't know what table sizes or you want to go for, that's why we have that process in place. And the time to be able to work with you and Nick on it, and all the brides and grooms that have so many different, you know, as we said, it's a blank canvas. So that's why we want to make the most of the space and how you guys envision your day to be.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm here for. So.
And you are such a little gem, And one of the things I really find, especially going through the planning, because this is the sell. Your finishing touches are just so beautiful and so stylish and kind of understated, so that you can add your own touches
exactly
if you wanted to.
Yeah, absolutely.
And it's just beautiful.
Yeah, and we're really proud of them. We are really proud, and we try and make them as bespoke to us as possible. You know, with the furniture, we've designed it ourselves and importing from overseas, and you know, it's just one thing that we're just constantly looking to be ahead of the trend.
Yeah,
and really setting them so that it is something that it's not dated, or you know, it's exactly what you guys, what we feel is fashionable as well. You know, house or fashion or just every day. That's what we want it to be like.
Oh, amazing. Actually, just talking to you guys, it's like, I wish that me and Luke were getting married next year. Like, I don't want this to end.
Aww.
I don't, honestly, I really, really mean this. I feel a bit like, I don't want it
to say.
Maybe we'll just put it off and then we just keep going. But no, thank you for talking to us.
My pleasure.
Amanda, amazing business.
Thank you.
Love it. And Kate, you're just a little angel of a wedding planner. Love you guys. So these are the team. All of the links are down below. Make sure you check them out, and Amanda will be at your service, Kate will be at your service. And if you have any questions for me, because the wedding may have happened when you're watching this video, or you may be thinking of booking with them, please let me know and I will answer any questions and put you in touch with these guys.
Made it.
Yes.
I think it's the actual same one.
Absolutely made it. So John is DJing today at the Papakata Spring Open Day, which doesn't look like spring, does it? Blooming snowing outside.
No,
but you know,
a bit Baltic.
Show must go on. So John, obviously heavily involved in wedding DJing.
That's right, yeah.
I'm getting married in 4 months' time in one of these amazing sperry tents. But besides all of the incredible things that Papakata have to offer, music is a huge thing, thing on for a wedding day. What would you say is, where's the starting point for even thinking about creating a playlist for a wedding? Because there's so many different age groups.
Yeah, well, relationship with the bride and groom, you've got to make sure that you understand what they're after, where they're coming from, where the family's coming from. Spend a good amount of time talking about tunes, what do you like, what does your mum and dad like, what does your brother and sisters like, cousins, and do a little playlist together for about 30-40 tracks so we can talk about it properly, and then it's down on paper and we can build up a really nice event.
Please don't tell me that you do YMCA. Do you refuse?
Oh, no, I just save that till the end.
No, please, John, don't do that.
When it's time to leave.
You'll get outcalled. What about, if have you ever had it where the bride and groom have got completely different tastes of music?
Definitely.
Really?
Definitely.
Is that quite a challenge?
No, you just go with the bride. Just go with the bride every time.
See, Luke, yeah. House music, yeah?
you've basically got loads of different people. Everybody likes their own music. You've just got to try and cover for as many as you can by having a good conversation about what's going to happen.
Yeah.
Because if people don't like the song, they will leave, and it's 100%. Difficult to get it back, and nobody wants that on the wedding day.
Yeah, no, they don't.
Everybody wants everyone involved, having fun, and dancing as long as they can, whether it's a band or a DJ or anything.
Yeah. Thanks, John. So I've just left Papakata. I feel quite sad that I've left them because I don't know if I will see Kate or Amanda again before I get married. I really hope that I do see them again, but in all honesty, I cannot recommend Papakata enough. They are such a lovely company. Of course, they provide such incredible tents, whether you want a sperry or a teepee, but just the service you get is incredible. I actually feel like they're my friends. I generally feel like they're my friends now. I want to invite them to the wedding. So if you really want that kind of one-to-one personal service, then Papakata are the ones. Sometimes I've definitely experienced in wedding land that it can become quite corporate and you're just like, we're organizing a party here, guys. And Papakata advocate that. That's their tagline. The best parties happen in a Papakata tent. And I have my fingers crossed. I didn't even have fingers crossed, actually. I know that the wedding will be my wedding of my dreams, but also an incredible party. So I have left the link below to contact them if you want to, or if you just want to go and spy on their gallery, have a look at the gallery, get some inspiration. Perhaps you are getting married soon, perhaps you're little and haven't even thought about getting married. It's just a lovely website to look at. So one to pin for sure. But if you like the video, please give it a good old thumbs up, share it, and subscribe if you haven't subscribed already. And all my socials are also in the link below. And I will see you on another video. Bye.